Short bowel is when a patient doesn't have enough bowel to absorb the nutrients or the vitamins or even the fluid and electrolytes in order to survive ultimately. And patients who have got short bowel can either lose weight or they can get dehydrated. And that will be progressively worsening unless there's some form of support. The causes of short bowel do include vascular problems. When a patient loses blood supply to the gut, that's like having a stroke to your gut and bowel gets removed as a result of that. In addition, surgical complications are very common as a result of a cause of short bowel. And finally, the other key cause is related to Crohn's disease, which is an inflammatory condition of the gut that results in repeated or sometimes a large amount of surgery for those patients. The impact of short bowel to the patient is actually quite enormous. It's something that they will never have previously been able to have imagined. They will not have any experience within their family or even working life of patients in similar situations. It's a rare condition. So the unmet needs for patients with short bowel can be quite hard to identify because it's a rare condition. The reality is, though, what is really needed is expert care close to home. At the end of the day, that probably means educating the medical profession as a whole, the healthcare community, about patients and about the condition of short bowel. To decrease the burden for patients with short bowel, probably the most important element is to try and decrease the amount of time that they need parenteral support. So the management and care of patients with short bowel involves a large team, or it should involve a large multidisciplinary team with a patient that can draw upon the expertise of that team at different time points along their path. The thing that can be achieved, having a large multidisciplinary group of experts looking after a patient, is almost, I would like to say, there are almost no limits. You don't have to achieve great things. You possibly just have to achieve as normal a life as possible. And that is the real goal for any multidisciplinary team. The one thing I would say that for me that really makes an enormous sense of satisfaction is when patients go on their first holiday and you get pictures or you get some sort of message. You know that you as a team have really helped that person achieve much more of a normal life, and they're not bound by the confines of the environment they're in normally, like their house. The one thing I really would like to bring out and possibly change is I'd like to take the failure out of intestinal failure. It sends the wrong message to patients, to teams. I would really like it to be called intestinal rehabilitation, as it sends the right message out, a positive message to everyone, both looking after those patients and living with the condition.